Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Have you ever heard of reports of foods that reduce your risk of certain chronic diseases? For example, dark chocolate has been proven through clinical studies to improve cardiovascular health. So why don't we have something like this for, say, colon cancer? Why colon cancer? Well, this cancer is one of the most preventable because the food interacts with our colon, which can cause inflammation, and that is one of the main causes of cancer. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's take a trip to a lab at the University of Massachusetts Amherst to see if they're being successful on their hunt for anti-cancer compounds for colon cancer prevention. Hi guys, how are
you? Hello, good, how are you?
Great. I actually am here at UMass because I've been reading about anti-cancer compounds, and I came across some work that you're doing on this very topic. And I wanted to get a little bit more information on the work that you're doing and why you're doing it.
Sure. So it's about fruits and vegetables. So there must be a reason why people recommend you to eat more fruits and vegetables to lower your risk of cancer.
You're right. I mean, fruits and vegetables have lots of vitamins, but what other nutrients are in here?
So it's called polyphenols. It's a micronutrient, just like vitamins and minerals. Mm-hmm. It only present in a tiny amount, and you only need it a tiny amount. But that matters, for example, to prevent inflammation, a cause of cancer. So we're looking at the type of polyphenol that is bound to fiber.
Okay.
That will protect them to survive the stomach, small intestine, and reach the colon. But the problem is, it's difficult to be extracted. That's why it has been ignored for so long.
Ah, so how do you extract the polyphenols to do your testing?
Fortunately, we know a technique how to break down the fiber that bounds to it and slowly releasing it. And that's where we can do the chemical extraction to get it out, and then we'll check how it inhibits the oxidation reaction in a plate culture, and then test it to anti-inflammatory inhibiting property in living cell culture. Mm-hmm. Well, eventually in the long run, we can test it on animal models for its anti-cancer compounds.
Well, it sounds like you've done the hard work in regards to finding a sample preparation protocol for
this. Pretty much.
So maybe you can take me to some data and show me what this looks like.
Sure, I'll let Yukun do that.
Let's go. Great, let's go to the whiteboard.
In our results on raspberry, we found that it has decent amount of NEPs that is at similar level with the free or extractable polyphenols. And after we tested it on living cells, the NEPs have higher anti-inflammatory activity, which is marked by the production of nitric oxide.
So you talk about tempeh fermentation. What is that exactly?
So tempeh is a traditional fermented soybean food from Indonesia. It has been enjoyed for 300 years. It's affordable, nutritious, and sustainable. And it's shown before that it would increase the protein content, it would add the vitamin B12 content, and increase the regular polyphenol content. In this particular research, we want to see how it increases this hidden polyphenol content.
So non-extractable polyphenols, you've definitely sold me on those.
Sure.
But how can we leverage this in the industry?
So in the long run, you can imagine fermenting your beans, legumes, and nuts before you process it further to increase the amount and quality of this particular non-extractable polyphenols. It means increasing your product's value for colorectal cancer prevention.
Well, now you've piqued my curiosity, so maybe we can test some of the samples that you have here and see what the content is.
Sure,
let's go. Could polyphenols beat a colon cancer what dark chocolate is to heart health? This group at UMass is really doing groundbreaking work in understanding anti-cancer compounds and how we can best utilize them in our food supply to be proactive in preventing such diseases as colon cancer that we know are caused from inflammation damage. If you would like to learn more about this work, check out the link below. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.